everyone. Good morning. I'm Shreya Dondial. You're watching Mirror Now. Today, as Nirmala Sitharaman presents the first budget of Modi 3.0, she will be creating history. She would have broken Morarji Desai's record and become the first finance minister of India to have presented 7 budgets on the trot. Now, as we speak, the finance minister has reached North Block and she is prepping for a photo op with the team that helped her make the budget. Post that, there is a string of protocols, including meeting the president and then finally arriving at Parliament at about 11 o'clock. Her budget speech will have to pack in a lot this year, given the changed political circumstances in India. The BJP, for the very first time in 10 years, doesn't have a majority in the Lok Sabha and is dependent on very demanding allies. Over the next few hours, ladies and gentlemen, there'll be a lot of jargons and zeros that will be thrown at us, numbers that we probably won't understand. The government will tell us how much income it has generated, how much it has spent, and where and how much it borrowed to meet the gap between income and spend. Essentially, it will tell the country the health of India's finances. It will also tell us how it intends to spend money over the next 1 year. As you hear Nirmala Sitharaman speak, just remember one fundamental truth. There is no such thing as government money. It's all taxpayers' money. Paisa aapka hai. So budget bhi aapka hai. So the obvious legitimate question to ask is, will the government ease the burden on the beleaguered taxpayer who's taken for granted most of the times? First things first, look at the numbers. Only 2 crore people pay taxes in this country. That is the truth. For every 100 rupees that the government collects, 29 rupees comes from income tax. 27 rupees comes from corporate tax, 28 rupees comes from GST, and 16 rupees comes from other taxes, which means Indian citizens, you and me, pay more taxes than corporate India. Now, the government, of course, needs money. Taxes are the lifeline for India's economy. The government needs to fund its flagship schemes, like 86,000 crores for MNREGA, 7,500 crores for Ayushman Bharat, and the big one, 12 lakh crores to give free food grain to 81 crore Indians. All of this requires money. That money comes from the taxes we pay. So therefore the question, will India's middle class, sandwiched between the poor and the super rich, find a voice in this budget? Will Nirmala Sitharaman have some mercy on India's taxpayers? We'll see what she says at 11 o'clock. First, let's hear from MOS Finance, Pankaj Chaudhary.
प्रधानमंत्री जी का जो मंत्र है सबका साथ सबका विकास और जिस प्रकार से आपने देखा होगा कि सदैव बजट राष्ट्रहित में आता है उसी प्रकार से ये भी बजट आएगा।
I think this government always tends to have a very rosy-colored view of the economy and its own role in it. So it is, in a way, almost expected that it would downplay the serious problems that exist and overplay any minor successes. So I think the problem is that it's not recognizing the real concerns. The real concerns are inflation, especially food inflation, and rampant unemployment and inadequate job creation. So it has kind of recognized them, but it's pretending that these are relatively minor, and it's more or less suggesting that the government has no role, that the job is that for the private corporate sector.
Okay, before the budget, there is only one thing that we can ask people today who are joining us on the show. What are the expectations and are those expectations real? Ashneer Grover is someone all of you know. I don't need to introduce him to you. Ashneer, thank you very much for your time here on Mirror Now. As an Aam Aadmi, we'll talk about startups, etc. later, but as an Aam Aadmi, what is your expectation from this budget?
For me personally, you know, all of these budgets are non-events. Essentially, you know, India is growing somewhere around 6 to 7%. A bad budget would mean India grows at 6%. A good budget means India grows at 7%, right? But they're not changing the or they're not moving the needle, very frankly. And that's why, if you see, other than moving the markets for 1 or 2 days, all these budgets are absolutely non-events. My expectation from a great budget is if it does something fundamentally different. I would be pleasantly surprised if that happens on the 23rd. And that's what pleasant surprise that I'm looking for from the budget.
Okay, when you say fundamentally different, for the salaried middle class, the only thing fundamentally different will be income taxes. Are you hoping that this pleasant surprise comes from the income tax bracket? Ki kuch khushkhabri to ho India ke taxpayer ke liye.
Yeah, ऐसी होता क्या है कि आप बजट में देखेंगे बड़े बड़े नंबर्स की बात होती है किसी सेक्टर को 50,000 एलोकेट कर दिए किसी स्कीम में 1 लाख करोड़ एलोकेट कर दिए यू नो आप व्हेन सो मेनी जीरोस आर इन्वॉल्व लेमैन के सर के ऊपर से निकल जाता है किसी को कुछ समझ नहीं आता क्या हो रहा है एंड ऑफ द डे एक लेमैन को क्या चाहिए तीन चीजें उसको पता करनी है टैक्स क्या है कि मैं घर जो पैसे लेके जाऊंगा वो कम होने वाले हैं ज्यादा होने वाले हैं प्राइसिंग में क्या है जो मैं प्रोडक्ट्स कंज्यूम करता हूँ वो महंगे होने वाले हैं या सस्ते होने वाले हैं और तीसरा अगर कुछ की जॉब्स और फ्यूचर के क्या प्रोस्पेक्ट हो सकते हैं ये तीन चीजें दे लुकिंग एट नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट टैक्स फर्स्ट राइट व्हिच इज व्हाट मोस्ट पीपल लुक एट द बजट फॉर कि यार टैक्स ज्यादा हुआ या कम हुआ आई हैव बीन वेरी वोकल अबाउट इट आई थिंक इंडिया इज इन अ वेरी बैड डायरेक्ट टैक्स रिजीम इंडिया में 20% टैक्स के ऊपर बनता ही नहीं है राइट आप 20% के ऊपर जितना टैक्स लगा रहे हो लोग उसके पे नहीं कर रहे या उसको अवॉइड करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं या वहां पे अपना एफर्ट डाल रहे हैं उसका कोई फायदा नहीं है यू शुड हैव अ सिंपल सिंगल स्लैब 20% अबव 10 लाख ऑफ इनकम बिलो 10 लाख ऑफ इनकम आप जीरो कर दो अबव 10 लाख ऑफ इनकम 20% कैपिटल गेन शुड बी फ्लैट 10% नो कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ लॉन्ग टर्म शॉर्ट टर्म नो कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ लिस्टेड अनलिस्टेड कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता आपका कैपिटल गेन्स आप 10% टैक्स दीजिए आपका नॉर्मल इनकम है आप 20% टैक्स दीजिए देर शुड बी नो टैक्स फॉर सैलरी फॉर गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयज मतलब गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयज की सैलरी टैक्स से जा रही है और आप उस पर फिर से टैक्स लगा रहे हो उसका कोई मतलब नहीं है अगेन सो गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयज शुड नॉट बी टैक्स एट ऑल एंड आई थिंक द इवन द कॉर्पोरेट टैक्स रेट शुड बी द सेम एज इंडिविजुअल टैक्स रेट विच इज 20% And maybe what you can do is for listed companies, you can even give a more incentive and say that a listed company would have a tax rate of 15%. I think something of this sort happens. I would, you know, personally feel it's a great budget. Other than that, it's just, you know, routine.
Ashneer, I'll just say this, given your revolutionary ideas on taxes, especially direct taxes, for all you know, middle class India will start rooting for you as the finance minister. But for the moment, let's shift to your industry, the startup industry. Now, there has been a demand on angel tax relief, and it's been a long-standing demand. Do you see that happening?
No, I don't think, The thing is, आपको एक एज अ गवर्नमेंट कॉल लेनी पड़ेगी कि आप इंडस्ट्री को प्रमोट करना चाहते हो नहीं करना चाहते हो ऑल दीज एंजल टैक्स ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर डिपार्टमेंटल थिंग्स दे कांट शुडंट इवन कम टू द बजट आप एक अपने डिपार्टमेंट में बोल दो यार स्टार्टअप्स में एंजल्स को तंग नहीं करना है तो वो इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर नहीं तंग करेगा उसके लिए बजट तक नौबत ही नहीं आएगी बात पूछने की सो आई डोंट थिंक एज अ स्टार्टअप आई हैव एनीथिंग टू लुक अप टू इन द बजट other than the you know the fact that if for example agar aap capital gain hota hai aapko koi bhi aap stock sell karte ho ya aap listed unlisted jo bhi hai aap usko reinvest karte ho real estate mein to aapko uska set off mil jata hai aapko tax nahi dena padta I think if something of similar nature gets introduced for registered startups jo startups already government ke sath registered hai under the startup scheme unke liye introduce ho jata hai so I think that will be a boost and that will provide domestic money to the startups other than that I don't think any of the startups are expecting anything drastic from the government
okay thank you very much Ashni for